Throughout history, there have been people who have committed some of the most heinous crimes fathomable. For those crimes, they have been convicted and sentenced to death. Welcome to Death Row Executions, where we take a look into the lives of society's worst offenders. And now, your host, Air.
Hello everyone, today's video is on the last words of people who were executed in the United States in the year 2019. Robert Mitchell Jennings was a black male born on December 3, 1957, and he was sent to death row for killing a Houston police officer. He was 30 at the time of his offense, and he was executed in Texas on January 30, 2019 at the age of 61, and his last words were, "To my friends and family, it was a nice journey. To the family of the police officer, I hope this finds you peace and be well and stay safe. Enjoy life's moments because we never get them back." Dominique Hakeem Marcel Ray was a black male born on May 31, 1976. He was 19 years old at the time of his offense and 42 years old at the time of his execution, which took place on February 7, 2019 in Alabama. He was sent to death row for killing Tiffany Harville of Selma. A year before killing Tiffany, he killed two brothers, but he was not sentenced to death for those murders. His final words were in Arabic, and he said, "There is no God but God, and Muhammad is his prophet." Billy Wayne Coble was a white male born on September 9, 1948. He was sentenced to death for killing his estranged wife's parents, Robert and Zelda Vica, and her brother, Police Sergeant Bobby Vica. Billy was 40 years old at the time of his offense and 70 at the time of his execution. His execution was on February 28, 2019 in Texas, and his final words were, "That'll be $5. John William King was a white male born on November 3, 1974. John was 23 years old when he chose to act on his white supremacist views and kill an innocent black man by the name of James Beard Jr. He was executed on April 24, 2019 in Texas at the age of 44. His final word was no. Scotty Garnell Morrow was a black male born on March 2, 1967. He was sentenced to death for killing his ex-girlfriend. He was 27 at the time of his offense, and his execution day was on May 2, 2019 in Georgia. He was 52 at the time of his death, and his final words were, "I would like to extend my most sincerest and heartfelt apologies to the Young family, the Woods family, to Miss Latoya Horn. Sorry for all of the injuries and things that I have caused you. Sorry for all the pain and harm that I have caused these two families, and I would also like to apologize to my family for pain and heartache that I have caused them. If you could ever find it in your hearts to forgive, I would ask that you do that, and mostly for yourselves, because, you know, holding anger and hatred in your hearts only hinders you. And once you're able to forgive, you're able to move on in life once again. I sincerely apologize. That's it." Michael Brandon Samra was a white male born on October 2, 1977. He was 19 years old when he killed four people over an argument about his truck. His execution day was May 16, 2019 in Alabama, and he was 41 years old at the time of his death. His last words were, "I would like to thank Jesus for everything he's done for me. Thank you for your grace, Jesus. Amen." Donnie Edward Johnson was a white male born on January 15, 1951. He was sentenced to death for killing his 31-year-old wife, Connie Johnson. He was 33 at the time of his offense. His execution day was on May 16, 2019 in Tennessee. He was 68 years old. For his final words, he said a long prayer. Some things he mentioned in his prayer was about Jesus and asking for forgiveness for the ones participating in his execution. He was quoted saying, "They know not what they do." He then prayed for everyone who he hurt and thanked God for God's blessings, which included his attorneys and loved ones. After the drugs were administered in his body, he asked the warden if he could sing a song, which the warden agreed. Donnie then began singing, "They Know We Are Christians," and then he started singing the song "Soon and Very Soon" before his voice trailed off. The final lyrics from the song that he was able to speak were, "No More Dying There." Robert Joseph Bobby Joe Long was a white male born on October 14, 1953. He was sentenced to death for killing Michelle Sims. He was a serial killer, though, and killed approximately 10 women. His execution day was May 23, 2019 in Florida. Robert was 30 at the time of his offense and 65 when he was executed. His final word spoken was no. Christopher Lee Price was a white male born on September 4, 1972. He was sentenced to death for killing a pastor right before Christmas. He was 19 at the time of his offense. His execution day was May 30th, 2019 in Alabama, and he died at the age of 46. His last words were, "A man is much more than his worst mistake." Marion Wilson Jr. was a black male born on July 29, 1976. Marion was sentenced to death for killing Donovan Corey Parks in 1997. Marion was 19 at the time of his offense and 42 at the time of his execution, which took place on June 20, 2019 in Georgia. For his last words, he said, "I never took a life in my life." He then looked towards his friends and family and said, "I love y'all forever. Death can't stop it. Can't nothing stop it." Stephen Michael West was a white male born on September 16, 1962. He was 23 years old when he killed 51-year-old Wanda Romans and her daughter, Sheila Romans, in 1986, which landed him on death row. His execution day was August 15, 2019 in Tennessee. His final words were, "In the beginning, God created man." He then began to cry and was able to continue on with saying, "And Jesus wept. That's all." Larry Ray Swearingen was a white male born on May 21, 1971. Larry killed Melissa Trotter back in 1999. He was 27 at the time of his offense and 48 at the time of his execution that took place in Texas on August 21, 2019. For his last words, he said, "Lord, forgive them. They don't know what they are doing." Gary Ray Bowles was a white male born on January 25, 1962. Gary was a serial killer who killed 6 gay men. He was 32 at the time of his last offense, and he was 57 on his execution day, which was on August 22, 2019 in Florida. His last words were, "I'm sorry for all the pain and suffering I have caused. I hope my death eases your pain. I want to tell my mother that I am also sorry for my actions. Having to deal with your son being called a monster is terrible. I am so very sorry. I never wanted this to be my life. You don't wake up one day and decide to become a serial killer." Billy Jack Crutzinger was a white male born on October 5, 1954. He was 48 years old in 2003 when he killed 89-year-old Pearl McGorick and her 71-year-old daughter, Patricia Siren. He was 64 years old on his execution day, which was on September 4, 2019 in Texas. His last words were, "Hi ladies, I wanted to tell y'all how much I love you. Thank you for being here for me." Mark Anthony Solis was a Hispanic male born on January 27, 1982. He was 28 years old when he murdered 61-year-old Nancy Weatherly. He was 37 years old on his execution day, which was on September 10, 2019 in the state of Texas. His final words were, "I don't know if me passing will bring y'all comfort for the pain and suffering I've caused y'all. I understand the pain that I caused y'all." He added that he hadn't known if members of Nancy Weatherly's family would attend the execution, but that he was pleased that they did. "I'm just glad I got the chance to talk to y'all." As the drugs were administered, he turned his head towards Nancy's family and said, "I hope y'all forgive me." Robert Sparks was a black male born on February 13, 1974. He was 33 years old when he killed his wife and 2 stepsons. This triple homicide landed him on death row. His execution day took place in Texas on September 25th, 2019. He was 45 when he passed away. His last words were, "I'm sorry for the hard times, and what hurts me is that I hurt y'all. Even y'all too." Russell Earl Bucklew was a white male born on May 16, 1968. He was 27 years old when he murdered Michael Sanders. He was 51 years old on his execution day, which was on October 1st, 2019 in Missouri. His last words are unknown, but his lawyer did make a final statement before his execution. He is deeply grateful for those who have supported him and fought for him, and he is grateful for those who have heard and accepted his words of remorse. Because of his rare and severe medical condition, Mr. Bucklew faces very significant risks during the execution today. He has blood-filled tumors in his head and throat that often hemorrhage, and he is able to breathe only with the help of a tracheostomy tube. He is terminally ill, and the state accomplishes nothing by executing him. In fact, executing him only causes further harm and diminishes all of us as a society. It is not too late. Governor Parsons has the ability and power to change his mind. We hope and pray that he does. Charles Russell Rhines was a white male born on July 11, 1956. He was 35 years old when he killed his 22-year-old co-worker, Donovan Schaefer. He was 63 years old on his execution day, which took place on November 4th, 2019 in South Dakota. When it came to his last words, he directed his words towards his victim's parents. "Ed and Peggy Schaefer, I forgive you for your anger and hatred toward me. I pray to God that he forgives you for your anger and hatred toward me. He then thanked his defense team. Thanks to my team, I love you all. Goodbye. Let's go. That's all I have to say. Goodbye. Justin Grant Hall was a white supremacist gang member born on June 16, 1981. He was 21 years old when he killed Melanie Ruth Bilharts in 2002 in order to prevent her from reporting an assault. He was 38 years old when he was executed on November 6, 2019 in the state of Texas. His last words were, "To my mom and Morelia, I love you and I'm going to miss you all. I'm ready." Ray Jefferson Cromartie was a black male born on February 6, 1967. Ray was 27 years old when he killed a man named Richard in 1994. Ray was 52 years old when he was executed on November 13, 2019 in Georgia. His final word was no. Leroy Hall Jr. was a white male born on October 28, 1966. He was 24 years old when he killed his ex-girlfriend, Tracy Crozier. He was 53 years old when he was executed on December 5, 2019 in the state of Tennessee. His final words were, "People need to learn forgiveness and love and make the world a better place." Travis Trevino Runnels was a black male born on December 17, 1972. He was 30 years old when he killed a white prison employee just because he was a white prison employee. He was 46 when he was executed on December 17, 1972 in Texas. His final words were, "Woof, woof."